This morning in the Roadshow Kitchen, we are cooking with Chef Joseph Zacovic for GoProvidence.com from Elizabeth of Portofino's, and we are making what I'm calling the his and hers dish, because we all know Will does not really like seafood, but I do, so we're making a seafood and a veal dish.
Yeah, we're going to be making some pan-seared scallops today with you, and then Will is going to try his hand in rolling some veal.
So. Okay, all right, good. So we've got everything covered, a lot on the table here today. Tell us what we'll need for this recipe.
All right, for this recipe, we have simple things for, we'll start with the veal roulade. Obviously, you're going to need a veal cutlet. And we have our stuffing ingredients here, which is prosciutto, provolone, spinach, and tomatoes. We'll roll that, pop that in the oven, and then we'll make a sauce with tomatoes, mushrooms, Marsala wine, and a demi-glaze.
Excellent.
And then for our scallops, obviously, we're going to have scallops. We're going to pan sear them.
These are huge.
Oh, yeah, they're delicious. We have for our scampi butter, some onions, garlic, butter. We have a little bit of a veloute and some
velouté?
Herb. Veloute is a thickened chicken stock that it just gives the sauce a little bit of body, a little bit of savory to it as well.
Excellent. But they all sound like great flavors coming together, and a little surf and turf, if you will.
We'll take
on that as well.
We'll keep them separate, but you can put them together.
Definitely.
Yeah.
But we do have the combination of the two. All right, so something for everyone in the kitchen today. We'll get it cooking in just a little bit. Back to you.
It's going, Mary. How are you? We are GoProvidence.com, Chef Joseph Zacovic from Elizabeth's of Portofino, and we are making rosemary skewed scallops and veal portofino.
Portofino, yes.
Portofino. Okay, first up, what are we going to do?
Well, we have a pounded veal cutlet right here.
All right.
And we have our stuffing ingredients right here. We have provolone underneath, Danielle prosciutto, diced tomatoes, and spinach. We've seasoned both, and I'm going to turn it over to you, and you're going to take this, pop this on here, and do a simple roll.
A simple roll to you.
Simple roll, yes.
We will see. Okay, so now you said that I could probably pick this up in one shot.
Yes.
And place this on here. So I'm going to move this closer over.
There we go.
We'll place that.
Oh, look at that. Perfect.
Not so bad. Okay. All right, so we have that on there, and now we're going to roll, right?
Now we're going to roll.
Okay, we're going to roll it this way, correct?
Correct.
Okay, all right, so we'll take this and roll it. And how tight does this have to be? I mean, because there's a lot of...
Just make it end to end. Doesn't have to be super tight.
Okay. And do we use anything? Do we use string or anything else to tie it together?
No. It's actually going to stay together. If you take it and put it seam side down, we'll get you a little tighter here.
Okay.
A little tighter so it doesn't unroll.
Right.
Seam side down. Push that in.
In with that big hunk of butter.
In with that big hunk of butter.
Okay.
A little Marsala wine. And then we pop this in the oven.
Put that in there. And how long are we going to have this in there for?
Well, depending on what type of oven you have at home,
okay.
Like this nice one with convection, it's going to take a little bit less, but probably about 15 minutes to cook that.
Okay, about 15 minutes to get
it done. 350.
Now the veal, when I'm going to the the butcher shop, the market, what am I looking for when I get the veal?
Oh, you're looking for a top round veal cutlet, and take it home. I suggest pounding it again.
Okay.
Pound a little bit thinner. Take even thinner, more tender, and season it up, and that's
okay.
It.
Very good. All right, we have that in the oven. It's set on 400. We'll leave that in the oven for just a little bit. It is cooking away. In the meantime, back to you.
Back in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning, where rosemary skewered scallops and veal portofino is on the menu today.
Yes, it is.
Elizabeth of Portofino's. This is not Elizabeth, though. This is Joe.
No.
He's cooking up everything for us today, and... Where do we stand now? I think we need to get these scallops going, right?
All right, yeah. We're just preheating our pan, and you don't want to get it too hot. You don't want to see any smoke or anything like that.
Okay.
And we're just going to sear our scallops. Medium-high heat here.
Mm-hmm. Okay. A little bit of oil in that pan.
A little bit of oil. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Would you suggest a certain kind of oil to cook these in, or does it matter?
It doesn't really matter. You kind of want a less flavorful oil. You don't want to use extra virgin olive oil. You don't want to steal... from the scallops.
Mm-hmm.
It's very easy to do. That's why everything in here is very light.
Right.
Okay.
But we're just doing it on medium-high heat.
Mm-hmm.
We're adding some onions, some garlic. We're going to get some color on everything that's in the pan here. And then we'll flip them over. And then we'll deglaze. But
and those seem to cook up pretty fast.
Well, they get color on them pretty fast.
Mm-hmm.
They're not going to be done. But that's what you want to do. You want to sear the outside, seal in the moisture, and you're pulling off sugar and flavor, which we'll end up deglazing with and putting back into
that later,
a sauce.
Later on. Okay.
Excellent.
So we'll flip these over here.
And how long are these going to cook for? Just till I get the color?
You're going to flip them over, and then what I normally do is I'll put them in the oven to finish cooking.
Mm-hmm.
And there, that way you're not applying super high heat and cooking it too fast or browning everything too much.
Yeah, because I know when you have an overcooked scallop, that's That's just
nah, it just falls apart and tough,
and
yeah.
Forget it.
Oh, we're gonna hit a little white wine.
Okay. It's really sizzling away.
Oh, yeah, and we're gonna take a little bit of our velouté in there just for a little savory flavor.
And that was that, what did you say, that thick chicken stock?
Yeah, thickened chicken stock.
Thickened chicken.
And some herbs.
Put that in.
Fresh and dry. And then I always put a little bit of red pepper flake in there.
Just to get a little kick.
Just a little kick.
All right. I like that.
Oh, yeah, we can let that sit as well while we're doing multitasking over here. And over here, we already have a risotto that's par-cooked.
Now, this is always tough to cook, right? For some people I hear, you know, cooking risotto is very tough just to get it just right.
It can be, yeah. But it's a pretty simple technique, which you normally would do. I've already skipped these steps, and I've already done it already. Mm-hmm. But you normally take the arborio rice, and then you'll take it, put it in a pan, and you're going to toast it a little bit to seal it. And then you're going to pull the starch out. That's what takes a little bit of time.
That's why we just go to the restaurant.
That's why we just go to the restaurant and have you do it.
Exactly.
We
do all the work for
up.
You. But then you sit there and stir it. You're pulling the starch out. And it does take a while.
Okay.
And it does take time. So if you can, come to the restaurant. We'll already do it for you.
You have no problem doing it.
Exactly.
So I'm going to take these, put these in the oven.
Okay. And where do we stand on the temperature there?
Temperature, you can cook it at 350.
Okay.
And you're only looking for about 8 minutes. You're just looking to get it hot and cooked all the way through.
Right.
And that's it. And then over here, we'll do the risotto, which is just a little bit of heavy cream in there right now. Mm-hmm. Like I said, I've already par cooked it. I do onions, white wine, toast it, chicken stock in there. And then you have this, which I'll add more heavy cream to, mm-hmm. and a little bit of cheese. And then we'll cook this.
That'll bind it together.
That's all good stuff.
Oh, yeah.
That's all good stuff.
And the only
cream and cheese.
Yeah, cream and cheese. And the only difference that we do in this risotto going with the scallops is we do a little citrus blend in here, which we have lemon, orange juice, and lime.
Yum.
So put a little bit in there. And then once again, we always hit it with some
fresh herbs.
Basil.
Give it some nice color.
Parsley, yeah.
Yum. And you have the finished dishes over here. I got to say,
they say presentation
is everything.
They really do look beautiful.
Come on. This looks fantastic. This is the veal that, Will, you were rolling earlier.
Yes.
And then the scallops. And I love how you use the rosemary to skewer them.
Yeah. We add, as I'm cooking, also with the scallops, right before I plate them, I'm doing the skewers. And I take a little bit of the rosemary, put in the pan that's getting hot, and so you have a little bit of scent of rosemary as well in the sauce.
Yum. And of course, we can get these dishes at your restaurant. I'm sure you must be doing something for Mother's Day, too.
Mother's Day, we're doing our regular menu plus several specials, so come on in and see what they are.
And what's the address in case anybody needs
897 Post Road, Warwick.
Okay. Now we know where everything is.
Make your reservation now. Will and
Let's
I will try these dishes. Don't forget, you can find both recipes at WPRI.com.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you.